Hey guys, I'm Bert Woods and this is the Agilent ICP-MS Minute. This is where I take a few seconds of your time to show you some cool features, tips, and tricks on some of our products. Today, I'm going to show you a feature on our Agilent 8900 ICP-MS Triple Quad, and the feature is the product ion scan. Let's go check it out.
Okay, we're at the ICP-MS Mass Hunter software. To do a product ion scan, you simply set the Quad 1, Quad 2 masses, select product ion scan, and today we're going to do mass 48. This is an isotope of titanium. And here you can see quad 1 is locked, but quad 2 is wide open from mass 2 all the way to mass 275. And this entire run will take less than 100 seconds. Okay, let's look at the data. Here's mass 48 and its cluster ions that form an ammonia mode. Here you can see the clusters at 63, around 80, around 97, around 115, around 132, and around 150. Remember, this is only one of the isotopes of titanium. It also has isotopes at 46, 47, and 49, which will also have its own cluster ions that form either one mass up or one mass down, or two masses down if you're mass 46. But let's look at a couple other elements. Scandium is monoisotopic at mass 45. In its product ion scan, here you can see cluster ions form around 111, around 130, around 145. Those could interfere with other cluster ions of those of titanium if you do not have single AMU control over quad 1. Here's the product ion scan for vanadium at mass 51. Here's the unreacted portion at mass 51. But you also see cluster ions around 100, around 117, and around 134. Remember, these are similar in mass to those that we saw for titanium 48, and we can also have those at titanium 49. This is the importance of having one AMU resolution on quad 1, and this is the cool thing that you can do with product ion scan. This was the Agilent ICP-MS Minute. I hope this was beneficial, and look forward to doing more of these for you in the future.